OLAP stands for Online Analytical Processing. It is a type of software that allows users to evaluate data from various databases at the same time. It's a tool that allows analysts to obtain and analyze business data from various perspectives. So while designing the reports, you may want the report quarterly, half yearly, or yearly. That can be possible via these operations. The operations like grouping, aggregating, and joining the data is a common task for any analyst nowadays. These operations in relational databases consume a lot of resources. Data can be pre-calculated and pre-aggregated using OLAP operations, which actually speed up the analysis process. Right. Now, we can divide the OLAP databases into one or more cubes. So instead of processing the whole data at the same time, you can divide the whole database into an object called a cube in OLAP. The cubes are designed in such a way that creating and viewing reports becomes more easy for the users. And how the cubes look like? You might have seen a cube in games also. You might have played some games using the magic cube, right? In the same fashion, this OLAP cube look like. You can say it's a multidimensional structure of a cube. Well, on one side you have quarters, quarter one. For a company, there are four quarters, right? Quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, and quarter four, right? And on another side, you have the types of products like PC, book, shoe, clothes, and so on. Then on the third dimension, you may have the countries, or you can say territory, like United States, then Australia, and so on. So this represent this dimension, Z dimension represents, you can say that the territory, right? You can say X dimension represents here all the types of products of the company. And the Y dimension shows you the process performance of the company in each and every quarter. So at the core of the OLAP concept is always an OLAP cube. It's always a OLAP cube. The OLAP cube is a data structure optimized for very quick data analysis. The OLAP cube consists of numerical facts called as measures, which are categorized by different dimensions of the cube. OLAP cubes sometimes also called as hypercube in the data warehouses. Usually, the data operations and analysis are performed using the simple spreadsheet, maybe Excel, that you use in many operations, Microsoft Excel, right? Where the data values are arranged in rows and column format, in a very easy format, like rows and column format. This is ideal for only two-dimensional data analysis. That spreadsheets are very good for two-dimensional data analysis. If you want to do multidimensional data analysis, you must use OLAP operations. And in back of the OLAP operation, the heart of OLAP operations is nothing but OLAP cube. So from the databases, we can generate the OLAP cubes. However, OLAP contains multidimensional data, with the data usually obtained from different and unrelated sources. In your data warehouse, data comes from different sources, right? You can't say that it is only from one source. Maybe Oracle, maybe some other platform like MySQL, from Microsoft Access, or you can say, and so on. There are many sources of data which is coming to the data warehouse. So OLAP contains multidimensional data, with data usually obtained from different sources and which is already unrelated source. Using the spreadsheet is not an optimal option when such things are there in the data warehouse. A cube can store and analyze multidimensional data in a logical and orderly manner. Then how it works? Question comes to your mind, then how it works. A data warehouse would extract information from multiple data sources and formats it in a unique database, unique format of a database, like text or Excel sheet or multidimensional data, image format, or you can say video format. There are different formats available for formatting, right? The extracted data is clean. First of all, it is clean and transformed into the queue. The data is loaded into an OLAP server, or it is also known as OLAP queue, where information is pre-calculated in advance for further analysis. The means that the raw data that you collected from different sources has to be cleaned and then transformed into the OLAP queue, where your information is already pre-calculated in advance. Like you have seen in the previous diagram of the queue, the information is calculated quarterly, performance in the Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and so on. All the information of PCs will be stored into this particular column. Book will be stored here, like shoes will be here. You can say that it's a summary data for that particular OLAP queue, right? Now there, another question comes to your mind is, what are different operations that we can perform on an OLAP queue? Basically, there are five different operations that we can do on OLAP queue. Namely, one is roll up. First is roll up. Second is drill down. Third is slice. Fourth is dice. And fifth is pivot. It is also known as rotate operation. Now, what do you mean by roll up in OLAP? Roll up is also known as consolidation, or it is also known as aggregation. The roll-up operation can be performed in two ways. We can reduce the dimensions is one way. Another is by climbing up concept hierarchy, we can also perform roll-up operation. Concept hierarchy is a system of grouping things based on their order or level. To understand this, we'll see one diagram. Consider the following diagram. Here, you have a cube, say like this. You just concentrate on the bottom part of this cube. This is a cube having the information of all the quarters, performance of a company in all the quarters. On the x-axis, you have the information of the items of the company, product of the company. On the another axis, you have the information of the cities or countries into that territory. Then how a roll-up operation can be performed on this. Now if you see the city information, New Jersey, Los Angeles, Perth, Sydney, these are different cities from different countries, right? But if you see, if I want to find the information country-wise, the sales of this company country-wise, then I must merge the information of different cities of the same country, like New Jersey and Los Angeles may be clubbed into USA. Perth and Sydney, this belongs to the country Australia. So this will be merged into one country, that is Australia, right? So here, a roll-up operation can be performed on cities, so that cities can be rolled up to countries. So the roll-up operation we are applying on this particular cube on cities, so that they can be converted into countries. Roll-up on location, if you perform from cities to the countries, then a new queue you will find wherein certain dimensions, the city dimension is now removed. You can see here, previously there were many cities. Now it gets reduced to a country. You can see now, you can see this particular row here, USA, only one line, Australia, only one line, right? Under Australia, there are two cities like Perth and Sydney. Under USA, there are two cities, New Jersey and Los Angeles. So by roll-up operation, we can merge the cities into countries and we can check the performance country-wise. So roll-up operation is nothing but it reduces the dimensions. There were four rows you can see here, but now they get converted into two with the help of this roll-up operation. In this particular example, the cities like New Jersey and Los Angeles are rolled up into country USA. Similarly, the cities like Perth and Sydney get rolled up into Australia. The sales figures of New Jersey and Los Angeles, which belongs to the USA, are now added. That is 440 plus 1560 respectively gets added, and that goes to 2000. If you add these two figures, it goes to 2000. So it is the sales of USA. After roll up, it becomes 2000. In this aggregation process, data location hierarchy moves up from city to the country. In the roll-up process, at least one or more dimension need to be removed, or it should be clubbed into one. In this example, the quarter dimension is removed, you can see. Another operation is a drill down. It is exactly reverse process of roll-up. In drill down, data is fragmented into smaller parts, and we consider this drill down process is the exact reverse process of a roll-up operation. It can be done via two ways. We can move down the concept hierarchy, or it is also known as increasing a dimension. To understand this, we'll see one example. Consider this cube, part of this diagram. There is one cube having the information of all the quarters. On y-axis, on the x-axis, you have say information of the products, and z-axis, you have say information of the countries, cities, city information, right? Now, if I perform the drill down operation on the quarters, if I perform drill down operation on Q1, every quarter has 3 months into it. It's the information of one quarter, Q1. Q2 is the information of another quarter. Q3 is the information of third quarter. Q4 is the information of sales of the company for fourth quarter. Now, if I perform drill down operation on the quarter, then it gets converted into months. So when I perform the drill down operation on the month, you just have to focus on the y-axis. But everything things will be as it is. Only focus on y-axis. When you perform drill down operation on the quarters, it gets converted into months. So the first quarter has 3 months: January, February, March. Next quarter would be April, May, June. Third quarter would be July, August, September. And the fourth quarter would be October, November, and December. So this particular information of sales, of say, the last column you can see here, there's 400, that gets divided into 3 months. Q1 sales of closes gets divided into these figures, like 150 plus 100 plus 150. So if you add all these values, it comes to 400 again. So it means that the sales information for closes for quarter one, which was 400, if you drill down it to the months, you get the information month-wise sales of that closes. So this type of operation is known as drill down operation in MOLAG. Quarter Q1 is drilled down to months like January, February, and March. Corresponding sales are also registered. In this example, dimension ones are added. It means you are adding more dimensions to the existing dimension. Quarter gets converted into 3 months, right? So you are adding some dimensions to the existing cube. That process is known as drill down process. Then the third OLAP operation is slice. Here one dimension can be selected at a time. One dimension is selected and a new sub queue can be created. for bed analysis. Consider the following diagram to understand size operation. Here, there is a cube having the information of quarter, products, and the cities. And if you perform, suppose, a slice on quarter Q1, I just want to know information of quarter Q1 about this company. So I will perform slice operation on time equal to Q1. If you do that, you will get a new subcube like this, which has now only two dimensions, like item and cities. And this particular is subcube is considered as one slice. So this information gives you the information of product and cities. Here, dimension time is sliced with Q1 as the filter. A new cube is created altogether. The next dimension operation is dice. This operation is similar to a slice operation, but there is a slight difference. The difference is in dice is you select two or more dimension that results in a creation of a new subcube. So in slice you can select one dimension, whereas in dice you can select more than one dimension at a time, two or more dimensions. So consider this particular cube, suppose this one, which has the information of product, quarters, and the cities. And now you want to perform, say, a dice operation on more than one dimension or more than two dimensions. Like you are going to perform dice operation on location, you want information of only Perth or Sydney, and time, like you just want the information of Q1 or Q2 quarter, and items or products should be on the books or cruises. So this type of operation, you can apply multiple filters via dice operation, so that you can select more than one or more than two dimensions at the same time, and a new cube would be created when you apply this particular dice operation. A new cube would be created like this, which has only the information of books, closes, quarter one, quarter two, and the cities would be Perth and Sydney. So this is possible with the help of dice operation in OLAP. Now the last operation in OLAP is pivot operation. In pivot operation, you rotate the data axis to provide a substitute presentation of the data. You can provide alternate presentation of the data via pivot operation. In the following example, the pivot is based on the item types. Consider this example. Suppose there are this is one subcube, on that you want to perform pivot operation. Right now, you can see here there are two dimensions. One is products, and another is having information of the cities, locations. Now, if you want to perform pivot on this, what will happen? This information of product will go on the y-axis, whereas the information of cities will go on the x-axis after rotation. The output after pivot operation, product information which was there on x-axis now gets rotated to y-axis, whereas information of cities now came to x-axis. This particular operation is known as pivot operation in OLAP. Now let's check the summary what we have studied till now. OLAP is a technology that enables analysts to extract and view business data from a different point of view. At the core of OLAP concept is an OLAP cube. Always there is a OLAP cube in the background. Various business applications and other data operation requires the use of OLAP cube. There are primarily five types of analytical operations that we perform on OLAP cube. That is, first is roll up, next is drill down, third is slice, fourth is dice, and fifth is